This is a storyteller show. This is story is about Pinky Fish and Birdie. So Pinky Fish was very happy. She was swimming around and she was very happy. Na 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 na. I am so happy. I love swimming. And there was a birdie in the sky. It was flying in the sky. It was going so happily. It was saying, "Oh, I am so happy. It is so beautiful. I love to fly in the sky." And suddenly the birdie looked down the fishy and said, "Oh God, I wish if I could swim like Pinky, then I would be very happy." And the fishy also looked up in the sky and said, "Oh God, I wish if I could fly in the sky, then I would be very happy." But suddenly all whales both switched their roles, but and now the birdie goes into the river to swim, and the fishy tries to swim and duck comes out of water.
Hello ma'am and my dear friends, my name is Jamie. A lamb crazy with the frog of sheep one day. She soon found some sweet grass at the edge of the field. Farther and farther she went away from other. She was enjoying herself so much that did not notice a wolf coming never to her. How when it pounces on her, she was quick to start playing. Please don't eat me yet, my stomach of the grass, full of the grass. If you bite a willy, I will taste much better." The wolf thought that was a good idea, so he sat down, waited. After a willy, the lamb said, "If you ask me to dance, the grass in my stomach will be digested." Again, the wolf agreed. Willy the lamb dancing. She had a new idea. She said, "Please take the bell from around my neck. If you ring it as hand you can, I will be bell to dance even faster." The wolf too the bell and ringing too faster. The sheep heard the bell and quickly run to find the missing lamb. The sheep heard sing, frightened the wolf and saved the lamb's life. Thank you.
Good morning friends and my dear friends. Hello, my name is Anam. I study in class 7. This story is about a little lamb and a wolf. A lamb was grazing with the flock of sheep one day. She soon saw some sweet grass at the edges of the field. Farther and farther she went away from other. She was enjoying herself so much that she did not notice a wolf coming nearer to her. However, the hermit pounced on her. Shiva starts pleading, "Please, please, please, don't eat me yet. My stomach is full of grass. If you wait a while, I will taste much better." The wolf thought that was a good idea. So he sat down and waited. After a while, the lamb said, "If you allow me to dance, grass in my stomach will be digested faster." Again, the wolf agreed. While the lamb was dancing, she had a new idea. She said, "Please take the bell from around my neck. If you ring it hard as you can, I will be dancing even faster." The wolf took the bell and ring it faster. The sheep heard the bell and quickly ran to find the missing lamb. The sheep heard, it frightened the wolf and saved the lamb's life. Thank you.
Hello, respected ma'am and my dear friends. Today I am going to tell you a story, A Small Lamb and a Wolf. A lamb was grazing with the flock of a sheep one day. She soon found some sweet grass at the edge of the field. Farther and farther she went away from others. She was enjoying herself so much that she did not notice a wolf coming nearer to her. However, when it pounced on her, she was quick to start pleading, "Please, please, don't eat me yet. My stomach is full of grass. If you wait a while, I will taste much better." The wolf thought that it was a good idea, so he sat down and waited. After a while, the lamb said, "If you allow me to dance, the grass in my stomach will be digested faster." The wolf Again, the wolf agreed. The lamb was dancing. She had a new idea. She said, "Please take the bell from around my neck. If you ring it as hard as you can, I will be able to dance even faster." The wolf took the bell and rang it faster. The shepherd heard the bell and quickly ran to find the missing lamb. The shepherd sighed, frightened the wolf and saved the lamb's life. The moral of the story is, the gentle and the weak can sometimes be cleverer, the fierce and strong. Thank you.
Good morning, ma'am and my dear friends. My name is Isika. Hello friends, this is a storyteller. So this story is about Pinky Fish and Birdie. The Pinky Fish was very happy. She was swimming around and she was very happy. Na 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 na. And there was a birdie in the sky. It was flying in the sky. And it was going so flying. It was saying, thank you.
Hello, ma'am and my dear fans. My name is Vansika. This is a storyteller. So this story is about Pinky Fish and Birdie. The Pinky Fish was very happy. She was swimming around and she was very happy. Na 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 na. I am so happy. I love swimming. And there was birdie in the sky. It was flying in the sky and it was going so happy. Thank you.
Hello, this is the storyteller show. This is story about Pinky Fish and Birdie. The Pinky Fish was very happy. She was swimming around in the river. Oh, I'm so happy. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. I'm so happy. I love swimming. And there was a birdie in the sky. It was flying in the sky. It was going so happily. It was saying, oh God, I'm so happy. It is so beautiful. I love to fly in the sky. And suddenly, there was a birdie looked down at the fishy and said, oh God, I wish I could swim like Pinky. There I would be very happy. The fish also looked up in the sky and said, oh God, I wish if I could also in the sky, then I would be very happy. Then suddenly they both swept their rosebud, and now the birdie gone into the